Welcome to a lesson on the DividerChooser method of fair division. In this lesson, we will define the DividerChooser method and also apply the DividerChooser method. The first method we will look at is a method for continuously divisible items. This method will be familiar to many parents because it is the you cut, I choose method. In this method, one party is designated the divider and the other the chooser, perhaps with a coin toss. Again, this method only applies with two players. The method works as follows. Number one, the divider cuts the item into two pieces that are, in the player's opinion, equal in value. The chooser selects either of the two pieces. Number three, the divider chooses the remaining piece. So as an example, let's assume Roberto and Alicia win a half pepperoni, half veggie pizza. Roberto likes both pepperoni and veggie equally, and he considers the value of the pizza to be $10. So because there are two players, a fair share for Roberto would be half of $10, or $5 worth of pizza. But since Alicia won't eat pepperoni, she considers all the value in the veggie side. The pepperoni side has no value to her because she's not going to eat it. She assigns a value of only $4 to the pizza since half of it is worthless. So notice for Alicia, a fair share would be worth $2. To apply the divider-chooser method, Roberto must be unaware that Alicia won't eat pepperoni. So Roberto becomes a divider and Alicia the chooser. Roberto then cuts the pizza exactly in half in such a way that one half is 1/4 pepperoni and 3/4 veggie. Meaning, he divides the pizza like this. If we look at this half here, notice that 1/4, or one of the four pieces, is pepperoni, and 3 of the 4 pieces, or 3/4, is veggie. So now it's Alicia's time to choose, and she has an easy choice. She picks the half that is 3/4 veggie and only 1/4 pepperoni, meaning she selects this half here. In her value system, this half is worth $3, which is more than half of the total value of the pizza, which she gave at $4. Remember, she put zero value on the pepperoni half and $4 worth of value on the veggie side. And because there are four slices of veggie, for Alicia, these three slices of veggie are worth $1 each, giving this half of the pizza $3 worth of value for Alicia. Of course, Roberto gets the other half, which for him is worth $5, which is exactly half of his total value of $10, which would be his fair share. Not only did each of them get a fair share or more, but they did it all by themselves without any outside intervention. This is what we mean when we say a fair division scheme must be internal. Now you might be thinking, if Roberto had ended up with all of the pepperoni and Alicia with all the veggie, Alicia would have been better off, and Roberto would have been the same. While this may be true, this does not matter because the result was fair. A fair division scheme is only required to give a fair division, not the best division. Now let's take a look at some more examples. Dante and Stephanie want to split a fun-sized bag of candy and decide to use the divider-chooser method. The bag contains 100 Snickers, 100 Milky Ways, and 100 Reese's. Dante values each at $3, $2, and $1 respectively, which means for Dante, 100 Snickers are worth $3, or 3 cents each. The 100 Milky Ways are worth $2, or 2 cents each, and so on. So if Stephanie is a divider, and in one half she puts 45 Snickers, 45 Milky Ways, and 65 Reese's, the question is, what is the value of this half for Dante, and is this a fair share? Notice how the total value for Dante is $6. Again, because there are two players, for Dante a fair share would be half of $6, or $3. But first, to find the value of this half for Dante, we'll multiply 45 Snickers by 3 cents and add 45 times the value for Dante for each Milky Way, which is 2 cents, plus 65 times Dante's value of each rhesus, which is 1 cent. So this will give us $1.35 plus 90 cents plus 65 cents, which gives a total of $2.90. So this half of the candy, according to Dante's value system, is worth $2.90, which is less than his fair share, because remember, his fair share was half of $6 or $3. So this is not a fair share for Dante. If this value was $3 or more, it would be a fair share for Dante. Now let's look at the same problem a slightly different way. They're still splitting this bag of candy, but Stephanie values each at $2, $1, and $3 respectively, which means the 100 Snickers are worth $2 or 2 cents each, the 100 Milky Ways are worth $1 or 1 cent each, and so on. So now if Dante is a divider, and in one half he puts 40 Snickers, 45 Milky Ways, and 65 Reese's, what is the value of this half for Stephanie, and is this a fair share? So again, Stephanie values each Snicker at 2 cents each, so we'd have 40 times 2 cents, plus each Milky Way is worth 1 cent each, so 45 times 1 cent, and each Reese's is worth 3 cents each, so 65 times 3 cents, so we have 80 cents plus 45 cents plus $1.95. So for Stephanie, the total value of this half would be $3.20. So again, notice how Stephanie's total value of all the candy would be $6, divided by 2 is $3. So Stephanie's fair share would be $3. And since $3.20 is greater than or equal to $3, this is a fair share for Stephanie. Let's take a look at one more example. We have a similar situation. Mika and Rosa want to split a bag of candy using the divider chooser method. And again, it contains 100 Snickers, 100 Milky Ways, and 100 Reese's, which Mika values at $3, $2, and $4 respectively, which again means each Snicker is worth 3 cents each, each Milky Way is worth 2 cents each, and each Reese's is worth 4 cents each. Notice in this case, the total value of all the candy for Mika would be $3 plus $2 plus $4, or $9, and since $9 divided by 2 is equal to $4.50, Mika's fair share would be worth $4.50. So if Mika is a divider, we want to find a possible division that is consistent with her value system. So the question only asks us for one, but there are many possibilities. We want to find a combination of Snickers, Milky Ways, and Reese's that would give a value of $4.50, again based upon Mika's value system. So for example, if we selected 50 Snickers, so far the value would be 50 times 3 cents, which would be $1.50. So we still have to add a value of $3 more worth of candy. Notice how if we added all the Milky Ways, that would be worth $2. We'd have 100 times 2 cents, which again is $2. Now we're up to a value of $3.50. We need to add $1 more worth of value using the Reese's. 100 Reese's is worth $4, which means 50 would be worth $2, which means 25 would be worth $1. So if we add 25 Reese's, again we'd add the value of 25 times 4 cents, adding a value of $1, giving a total value of $4.50, which would be a fair share based upon Mika's value system. And once again, there are many other possibilities that we can use to come up with a value of $4.50 based upon Mika's value system. I hope you found this helpful.